Hello everybody, I am Mrs. P. Jagadambal, Assistant Professor, Department of Human Development, Avinashlingam Institute for Home Science and Higher Education for Women, Coimbatore. Today we are going to talk about the planning process in Early Childhood Education Center. Each and every child is a unique individual. Each child possesses skills and abilities that can be further enhanced and developed. A good early childhood education program respects the various pace of development of all children and guarantees that the child develops into their full potentials in all the domains of development, namely physical, social, emotional, moral, and intellectual. So, the main aim of providing quality care and education during the early years is to facilitate the child to develop as a holistic individual and apprehend his or her potential to the fullest in all the areas of development. The program planning in an early childhood education center should address the interrelated domains of holistic development through an integrated and play-based approach which focuses on development of life skills. Early childhood education can be defined as an informal teaching-learning process which consists of activities and experiences which are intended to bring out changes in the developmental domains of children before entering into formal educational setup. Early childhood education includes all type of educational programs that serve children in the early childhood years and are designed to improve their later school performance. Early childhood education can instill substantial upshots in kids' wisdom and progress. The learning outcomes of this session will be: describe the program planning in early childhood education, outline the elements of good preschool program. Program planning is an essential component in imparting effective early childhood education service to provide quality education and care for young children. There are countless means in which we could plan things. Planning an ECE cycle has no beginning and no end. It continues as an ongoing cycle day after day, week after week, and year after year for the young children. The main purpose of program planning in ECE Center is to enhance and enrich the ways in which an early childhood educator should work with children to create a favorable teaching-learning environment. The early childhood education recognizes the best method of teaching-learning for children is play, because they love play and learn easily by doing rather than listening. Over the years, it was very much evident that the children of early childhood years are quite inquisitive to explore their immediate world by using their sensory motor skills. We can observe that young children are in constant interaction with their environment. They want to fondle everything they see. Furthermore, children learn by doing, by experiencing and actively participating in the learning process. In a nutshell, the learning processes in early childhood center should be based on the needs, interest, abilities and social context of the children for whom it is intended. A good schedule is predictable. That is, the sequence of events is always the same, although the actual clock time may vary a bit. A good schedule should be flexible too. Flexible time blocks allow for both predictability and flexibility. While the sequence of events is predictable, the early childhood educators can adjust the length of time for each block according to the children's involvement or restlessness. A good schedule should include a variety of developmentally appropriate activities. That is, the children should be able to explore a variety of materials. Activities should include all areas of development, namely physical, cognitive, social and emotional, language, lit and literacy. Children should be allowed to make choices and pursue their interests. Schedule should be balanced between child-initiated activities and adult guidance and support. A good schedule balances active and quiet, indoor and outdoor learning experiences. Alternating active and quiet activities help children avoid fatigue and boredom and helps them maintain self-control. Children need both indoor and outdoor experiences every day. A good schedule includes at least 1 hour of outdoor play in a suitable weather. Children will experience outdoor play for a portion of every day unless the weather conditions are extreme. A good schedule provides a reasonable pace for children's participation. A hurried schedule opposes a positive learning environment, leading to boredom and conflict. A helpful schedule allows time for children to complete tasks in a satisfying way. A good schedule should recognize the developmental differences in attention span. Most preschool children can sustain interest in self-initiated activities for a relatively longer period of time. During group times, 10 to 20 minutes is the expected attention span for most of the 3 to 5 year olds. To conclude, we can say that the early years in children's development are prominent in building their personality and shaping their character. Preschool offers an educational framework for children between the ages of 3 to 6 that significantly contributes to their development and addresses their needs at the start of their journey through the state education system. The curriculum is an educational tool to help the early childhood educators implement the preschool's educational goals into practice. It contains both educational and administrative elements that allow the childhood educators and her staff to organize and carry out their work. It is important that the curriculum be adapted to those who use it, and therefore it needs to be determined by the early childhood educators in conjunction with their staff.